Okay guys, here I am again with this amazing plant, Myrothamnus flabellifolia, the resurrection bush. And I'm going to talk you through some of the phytopharmaceutical characteristics of this plant. So firstly, it's been actively researched from a pharmaceutical point of view as a treatment for herpes. I don't know anything about what the compounds are in it. That's a derivative of some traditional knowledge and some modern scientific research. That research is ongoing. It also has significant quantities of various antioxidants in it, which are probably associated with its ability. Just as a reminder, this is the plant that completely dries up. Here's a dry twig, actually on this shrub here. And during the dry season, which is about 7-8 months long, it dries up like this and it looks as if it's dead. And then as soon as a little bit of water comes along, it miraculously comes back to life, hence the name the resurrection bush. Now, in part, and it is in part, the antioxidant compounds, which are beta-carotene, ascorbic acid, and gamma-tocopherol, they're all found in the aerial parts of this plant, and certainly they play a role in protecting and preserving it during this period of desiccation so that it comes back to life. But the real hero of that story is a sugar, actually, a carbohydrate called trehalose. And in this plant, of course, in any plants, there are lots of different sugars, carbohydrates. The dominant ones here are sucrose and trehalose. Now, sucrose, we would expect to find nothing unusual there. Trehalose is very unusual. Trehalose is predominantly found in yeasts, but very rarely in vascular flora. So this plant has trehalose. In fact, we for a long time, we didn't even think trehalose, you could find trehalose in a vascular plant. But this plant has it, and a few others. And the trehalose responds during the desiccation in a particular way, which is really interesting and suggests that it plays a key role in protecting the plant during the desiccation phase. And what it appears happens is that the trehalose is protecting the hydrogen bonds at the macro, between and within macromolecules during the desiccation process. And that retains the structure of the cell membrane, which allows the cells to rehydrate intact. So the remarkable ability of this plant is that when it desiccates, the cells are not damaged. So normally when it desiccates, the cell would dry up, it would shrink, and then it would break, it would crack. But in these, that does not happen. The cell membranes remain intact, and then when they rehydrate, they're perfect. Now, that has really, really, really significant potential to be replicated in a wide range, actually, but particularly interestingly in skincare. And I'm going to talk to you a little bit more about trehalose in skincare. But first, I'm now going to introduce you to the other magic compound that's found in this plant and not often found in other plants, and certainly not in combination with trehalose. And that is a compound called arbutin. The fact that it's found in this plant in significant quantities seems to suggest that it plays a role in protecting it during the desiccation. Arbutin is found in a number of other plants and very often found in plants that do undergo severe stress, such as plants growing in extreme Arctic conditions. And the way it works, so it's a source of hydroquinone, and the arbutin, and what it does is it inhibits peroxidation of the unsaturated lipids, and that peroxidation is what's going to cause damage within the cell during the desiccation. And the fact that arbutin is present and inhibits that process then plays a very significant role in protecting the integrity of the cells. And the other compounds that also contribute to protecting the integrity of the cell walls are the tannins and polyphenols that are found in this. Now, researchers have looked at the tannin levels in a fresh plant and in a dried plant and found the tannin levels are much higher in a dry plant. As it desiccates, the tannins strengthen. And really interestingly, in its dry form, resurrection appears to be almost completely immune to any form of fungal infection, which again would imply very high levels of tannins. The tannins also make it unpalatable to animals, although it is a fantastically delicious aromatic herbal tea. So the tannins, again, they also play a significant role in protecting the elasticity of the cell walls, so that during this desiccation process, the cell walls remain intact. So that's the third set of compounds or compound associated with allowing this plant to go through this desiccation process and recover itself, very remarkably. And now let's talk about how that would work or that would apply in cosmetic science to skincare.
Thanks for watching that, guys. My name's Gus, the African Plant Hunter, and it's my mission in life to bring little facts about African medicinal plants and share them with the rest of the world. So if you'd like to see more, you're very welcome to subscribe to my YouTube channel, Facebook, Twitter, African Plant Hunter. Just check me out there. I'm coming back with the second episode on this remarkable plant, Myrothamnus flabellifolia, the resurrection bush. Next time I'm going to be talking specifically about how those compounds I've just described are used in skincare formulations. I'll catch you later. Bye.